Assalamu alaikum and very good morning. Welcome to EBT318 Surface Engineering online class. Ladies and gentlemen, today we will proceed with the other types of vaporized deposition processes, that is physical vapor deposition or PVD. PVD have been used for producing different types of materials, including fibers, nanotubes, powders, thin films, multilayer coatings, and graded composition deposits, for many years. Different categories of advanced materials, including nanocrystalline and amorphous alloys, have been produced in the form of thin films, with thickness in the range between few nanometers and thousands of nanometers. Before we proceed to next slide, our class code is YNWA. As mentioned in the previous class, there are two strategies of producing thin films via vapor deposition technique, known as CVD and PVD. Generally, PVD coatings are thin film coatings where a solid material is vaporized in a vacuum chamber and deposited onto a target material. It is used to change the surface properties of the object to be coated, where new mechanical, chemical, electrical, or optical characteristics are needed to be in materials design. PVD process is carried out in a vacuum chamber at a temperature, normally in the range of 50 to 600 degrees Celsius. The evaporation atoms from the solid material travel through the vacuum chamber and condense themselves into whatever object or substrate on it paths. PVD normally use a high melting point and low vapor pressure materials as a target. Some of the target materials are titanium, zirconium, aluminium, stainless steel, and copper, or even gold for aerospace electronics. PVD technologies typically operate at very high temperatures and vacuum, requiring special attention by operating skilled personnel. In contrary to PVD, CVD is a method in which chemical adhesion or chemical deposition occurs, whereas PVD just involves a evaporation and condensation of pure materials. PVD is a variety of vacuum deposition and a general term used to describe any of a variety methods to deposit thin films by the condensation of a vaporized form of the desired film material onto various substrate surfaces. The coating method involves purely physical processes such as high-temperature vacuum evaporation with subsequent condensation, or plasma sputter bombardment rather than involving a chemical reaction at the surface to be coated as in CVD. The evaporated atoms were then travel through the evacuated space between the source and the sample and stick to the sample or substrate materials. Usually PVD does not involves any of chemical reactions. It carried out in a vacuum atmosphere and used for thin and uniform coating or films. Look at the figure here, this is a schematic diagram of PVD arrangement. It involves vaporization of a materials by way of resistive heating. The vaporized materials is subsequently deposited on a desired target as a thin film. This process relies on the fact that when heated, which is particularly under reduced pressure, there is a finite vapor pressure over all materials. Thermal energy is supplied by passing a large current through a crucible or ether gasket, which is a thermal tolerant materials, for example tungsten, to hold the materials. The resistivity of the crucible generates sufficient heat that the source material is vaporized as atoms. The vaporized source materials travels through a low pressure space, to become incident on target sample, where it condenses to form a film. The source material either sublimes or evaporates. Sublimes here, means a transition of solid to vapor phase. Whereas evaporates is transition of liquid to vapor via intermediate melting from solid to liquid phase. In most cases, the material is heated from solid to liquid before vapor. There the source materials is supported from beneath. Vaporized source materials rises upwards, towards a downward facing target material. This rate control is coupled with a movable shield, to allow specific film thickness deposition on the sample. Evacuation of the chamber gases is required before the source material can be deposited onto the sample. First, A rough pump reduces pressure the chamber to around 10⁻²⁰ pascal. Next, a turbo pump reduces pressure inside the chamber to less than or below than 10⁻²⁰ pascal. The stubborn absorbed molecules is then finally removed by the turbo pump, normally turbomolecular pump. Resistive heating vaporizes the source materials. Quartz sensor is used to set the vaporization rate. One desired rate is set, the shield is moved to reveal the sample. Resistive heating vaporizes the source material onto the sample. Then the vaporized source material impinges on the substrate surface where it settles and condenses. Once a film of desired thickness is obtained, the shield is returned to cover the sample and resistive heating slowly ceased. This results in a thin film of source material covering the sample surface. These are some PVD machine available in the industry. In the industries, PVD used in a wide spectrum of applications. The most common are semiconductors, CD and DVD media, tools, mechanical components, automotive components, solar cells, optics, biomedical, etc. PVD is an eco-friendly technology in contrast to chemical and galvanic surface treatment methods. It is clean and dry, with no hazardous materials involved, and does not generate chemical waste or water pollution. Green PVD coatings, for example, address controversial use of cyanide in plating baths for noble metals, and the use of hexavalent chromium for plating on plastic. The PVD method conforms to all environmental legislation and does not require environmental licenses. The use of PVD is increasing rapidly in the industry to replace less environment-friendly chemical and galvanic methods. So that, impact coatings technology can broaden the use of PVD to even more applications. The advantages of PVD process. PVD coatings are harder and more corrosion resistant than coatings applied by the electroplating process. The materials coated by PVD have high temperature and good impact strength, excellent abrasion resistance and are so durable. It means that the materials can be deposited with improved properties compared to its original substrate material properties. The process is more environmentally friendly than compared to processes such as electroplating. There are more than one technique utilizes a PVD concept can be used to deposit a given film. Almost any type of inorganic material can be used as well as some kinds of organic materials. Disadvantages of the physical vapor deposition process. The bad thing about PVD is it needs high capital cost to operate. Some processes operate at high vacuums and temperatures requiring skilled operators. It is a line of sight technique, meaning that it is extremely difficult to coat to undercut side of material surface. The rate of coating deposition is usually quite slow, resulting in less mass production. PVD processes requiring large amounts of heat and require appropriate efficient cooling systems to control the temperature. The applications of PVD process. PVD coatings are generally used to improve hardness, wear resistance, and oxidation resistance. Thus, such coatings use in a wide range of applications such as in electronics, aerospace, automotive, surgical and medical apparatus, dies and molds for all manner of material processing, cutting tools, firearms, optics, watches, decoration, jewelry, thin films, window tinted materials, food packaging, corrosion as well as wear prevention and protection and so on. Let's take a look at the application of PVD in the development of an organic light emitting diode or OLED.
OLED stands for Organic Light Emitting Diode, a special layer that glows when an electric current is introduced. Consumers are demanding better display. OLED displays satisfy that demand. They are brighter, lighter, thinner, and consume less power than LCD displays. OLED is superior than LCD. When you buy a cell phone these days, these phones usually have an OLED display. This is where you can see the big advantage offered by OLEDs. They provide very high contrast. OLED displays also very flexible. OLED also applies to organic solar cell that provide mechanical flexibility and choice of colors. OLED manufacturing can be classified into two categories, which is dry and wet. The dry manufacturing method refers to the conversion of raw organic material from solid powder form into gas phase. This method called thermal evaporation techniques that also used in manufacturing mirror. Next video shows using mini thermal evaporator coater, TH350. Thermal evaporation is one of the simplest of the physical vapor deposition, PVD techniques. Basically, the material is heated in a vacuum chamber until its surface atom has sufficient energy to leave the surface. The application of thermal evaporation are in production of food packaging, optical components, spectacles, solar cells, semiconductor wafer, lamp reflector, and many more.
The PVD process relies on the fact that when materials heated, which is particularly under reduced pressure, there is a finite vapor pressure over all materials. So that, the electron beam evaporation requires the source material to be heated in a high vacuum chamber with a pressure of less than 10⁻⁵ torr. A high vacuum is needed to minimize collisions of source atoms with the atoms of the background materials. For reasonable deposition rates, the vapor pressure must be approximately 10 millitorr. This makes it nearly impossible to evaporate some materials using thermal evaporation. Refractory metals must be evaporated using electron beam evaporation instead. Referring to the vapor pressure curves in figure 9 to 20 here, you can see the red circle mark where evaporating platinum would require a temperature of about 2000 degrees Celsius. This temperature is well beyond the operating range for thermal evaporation, 1800 degrees C. Meanwhile, electron beam evaporation could easily handle at the high temperatures. Because evaporation is an isotropic process, meaning atoms are evaporated off of the source in all directions equally, deposition uniformity becomes an issue. Thus, to combat this problem, manufacturers use spherical wafer holders to control the temperature uniformly. Even the issue of deposition uniformity is not completely solved, however, since wafers directly above the crucible will be coated more heavily than wafers off to the side. Referring to the chart of vapor pressures of various metals here. Refractory metals, such as tungsten, require temperatures in excess of 3000 degrees Celsius to reach a vapor pressure of 10⁻²⁰ torr. Other metals, for example, gold and aluminum, require much less heat.